Well, good morning. This is the talk of the town. I'm Faraz, and our guest this morning is Professor Indika Karunatilaka, and he's a medical man. He'll tell you what he does soon after I stop speaking. Well, good morning to you, Professor.
Very good morning. Currently, I am the president of Sri Lanka Medical Association, and as SLMA, we have done a lot of work related to the prevention of COVID-19, especially related to the capacity building, and we are very keen about getting the correct rational scientific message across to the general public.
Ah, that's very good, because then you're just the man on the phone, because I wanted to ask you about the picnic in the forest kind of thing, where thousands of people went in search of the magic potion, the penny, that was supposedly a vaccine of some sort for COVID-19. Tell me about that. Is that really possible?
Okay. I mean, if I get back to the basics, there are scientifically proven methods to avoid getting the infection.
Right.
They have been worldwide, they have been proven to be effective. They are, first, maintaining physical distancing. Secondly, correct wearing of face mask. And thirdly, avoiding going to crowded, congested places and maintain hand hygiene. Those are the four main things. And there are scientifically proven methods of preventing the spread of the epidemic. That
right.
is early detection, contact tracing, and isolation. One thing I want to say is most of those who are affected are actually asymptomatic, about 85%. And
right.
they don't actually need any medicine. They just need supportive treatment and isolation from the community so that they will not be spreading the disease to the others.
Right.
And about within, say, 10 days or so, they will cease to become infective.
Uh-huh.
So after that, they can go home and spend the time on home isolation. That's all they need, most of them.
So are you saying then, doctor, that this concoction or this potion or however we want to label it, that this is really it gives some relief, because that's anything sugary will give somebody having a respiratory issue, they'll give them some relief because it's a sugar. Is that what you mean?
That's possible. That's possible. Again, now, when you introduce a treatment or a remedy as a new treatment, there is a worldwide accepted scientific protocol
right.
and ethical guidelines to be followed.
And what is that? In short, what is that guideline? How does one get a medicine approved for whatever purpose?
Yes, I mean it is a long process because simply it's for the patient's safety, because ultimately whatever drug we need to have the assurance that it is safer
mm-hmm.
for the people to use, effective and safe. That is very important. That is why these guidelines where you test the drug maybe with the animals and then move into a smaller sample of humans and then moving into a larger sample, like that procedure has to be followed, because mm-hmm. you have to make sure that it is effective and safe. And secondly, since you are doing these studies on animals and human beings, there are very strict ethical guidelines to be followed.
Right.
So those things, I mean, you can't deviate from those procedures, whether it is, say, from the natural substances or chemical substances, you can't deviate from these procedures. And what you mentioned was actually very correct. Now, I can't comment on this preparation because no details are really available about what are the exact substances, so on and so forth.
Yeah.
What you mentioned is very correct. If someone is having respiratory symptoms, say sore throat, then any preparation with high sugar content, it can be honey, or it can be bee's honey, or it can be syrup, can give temporary relief. Because
mm-hmm.
what happens is this high sugar content can coat the inflamed surface in the throat.
Yeah.
And that will give the relief. But it cannot kill the virus that has gone into the cells and then started multiplying
mm-hmm.
and started an inflammatory reaction.
Right.
And worldwide also, there is no drug that has gone through that procedure that I have mentioned and proven beyond doubt that it is safe and effective and able to kill the virus. There's
right.
no such that has proven at that moment.
Mm-hmm.
What I want to say is,
yeah.
if undue prominence is given for unproven remedies,
yeah.
what will happen is it will deviate the attention from the essential preventive measures, and that can jeopardize the preventive strategies.
And
that's
what
the
about,
biggest danger I've seen.
And also, what about the risk of all these people, thousands and thousands of people gathered there, for some at some points of that gathering, perhaps challenging this this social distancing and so on?
It's very possible. It's possible that, I mean, there may be some who have got the infection and the spreading is possible. It depends on what kind of places, because in the open air, sometimes the risk may be minimal, but when you go into confined spaces, then there will be very high risk. So it depends, but it is possible. What actually I see a bigger risk. The bigger risk is when it comes to prevention and control of this epidemic, lot depends on community empowerment.
Right.
Empowering the community and okay. capacity building.
Okay.
What will happen is these kind of activities and these kind of mindsets will damage the community empowerment and community capacity building, and that will do worse harm to the control mechanism. That's the biggest danger I am seeing. And that might undo all the hard work that was done over the last 1 year. That's
wonderful.
The biggest danger.
Thank you very much for your time, Professor Indika.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And it's now back to the morning fix with Dom and Asanka, who manage to keep themselves safely distanced, Shehan, don't they? Thank you.